This is a reconstruction of a hall of a Buddhist cult center consisting of a few monasteries. It was found in the settlement of Old Hermes. This is the territory of ancient Bactria, and it was built in the 1st century AD. You completely lose all sense of time and space there. Clay and Ganj sculptures, as well as fragments of paintings decorating the monastery, are still found here. Dr. Tigran Mikertichev took part in the excavations in Kara Tepe in subsequent years. This was a joint expedition. Experts from the State Hermitage Museum, as well as Samarkand Museum and our own museum, took part in it. This was a joint archaeological expedition that lasted over 30 years. Kara Tepe is a staging area on the way from India to China. I imagine that this was the place where Buddhist cult architecture began to form, for instance, the cave that was first moved from India to Bactria in Uzbekistan and later on to China. Old Termes, or Tarmit, as it was called, was not just a religious center, but also the center of the caravan trade. No wonder that perfectly formed red clay pots were found here. Some of them display ornamentation. Monks who lived and meditated in the monastery may have eaten or drunk from them. Gradually, towards the end of the 4th century, the monastery fell into disrepair, and when the Arabs came here in the 7th century, it was already a ruin. But unique artifacts were still to be found. Fragments of clay and Ganj sculptures are the star of the museum's collection. They demonstrate the great skills of the unknown sculptures of ancient Bactria, who even in the 3rd century could depict the place, ethnic type and emotions of their characters so vividly and accurately. Bodhisattva's head wearing a turban is a classic of Buddhist sculpture of that time. What is more interesting is that, despite many studies, Buddhist characters remain mysterious in their own way. And it is also the place where the unique exhibit, Buddha's head, is kept, with a mysterious and amazing smile resembling that of Mona Lisa. The ancient sculpture was generous in gilding the god's face. The archaeological heritage of Uzbekistan is quite diverse. That rectangular ossuary was meant for Zoroastrian funeral rites. It was found in the settlement of Durman Tep near Samarkand and dates back to the 7th century. This was the time of the Sogdian state in what is modern Uzbekistan. Varaksha Palace near Bukhara, the walls of which were covered with rich Ganj decorations and narrative paintings, was another Sogdian monument. A man's head. This may be a portrait of a governor of Bukhara in the 7th or the 8th centuries. They were known as Bukhar Khudas. A lion's head, a fragment of a composition of hunting scenes. Sogdian sculptures deserve recognition for mastering the secret of sculpture that sets no limits on the imagination.